establish like a working groove, you know, for the different, you know, parts of the song. As the song progresses, obviously the groove will intensify. So we want to start really improvising now on the groove. Some simple things to look at. You know, again, pay attention to what's already there, what the band is giving you, the keyboard player, the drummer, you know, whatever other instruments, you know, you may have playing along with you. So as a bass player, my goal is to always, you know, establish a groove. Even as I'm improvising, it's got to be based on a groove. Again, when we're building a lick, we want to be conscious of two things. We want to be conscious of the rhythm of the lick and the chord progression underneath the lick. And another goal is to try to connect the licks to the next progression in the song, which is nice. You don't always have to hit the root note of the next progression, but just something, you know, that is related to the next progression and not just completely independent of what's going on musically. So let's keep the progression going even as we're ad-libbing and improvising. Patterns, you know, that you probably hear a lot and may do like in some passing licks. But the goal is to try to connect them together to where now it's musical and not just random playing, you know, and not just things that just come out of nowhere. And that's what really makes a song sound musical. That's what makes people want to hire you to play. Because again, the groove is the key. So even in the basic ad-libbing that I was, you know, trying to incorporate, everything was centered around the groove. I haven't really stretched out on anything yet. But everything has got to be groove-centered, right? So even as we get into the longer runs and more of the eighth note runs that reach up and down the whole range of the bass, we want to kind of keep the groove as the center of everything we're doing, okay? So let's see what we've come up with, you know, and we'll try some things. I'll just find a really basic groove and just really try to build upon that, you know. All they would do is take like a melody or a head or even for this matter a groove and simply just kind of expand on that, you know, that was enough. And everything we do from soloing would simply expand from our improvising. You know, so maybe we add a few more notes. Maybe, you know, we manipulate the rhythms a little bit. There's always some type of concept that is connected to the foundational groove. So I hope you guys enjoy this. Hope that this information kind of helps you out, gives you some more direction.